समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुकुलां श्री स्मृति प्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनामूर्ति सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विजहाति पूर्व वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुं हदेवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचित्रे सुखम इच्छम सत् प्रकाशम व्यापकं नाम रूप अधिष्ठान बुद्धे बुद्धि बुद्धे प्रख्यत्व निर्मलम अपारम सर्व वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहं नमस्तु नित्य में निश्चिता मतिः। थ्री सेवेंटी फर्स्ट आवर का शेष अंतकरण अध्यजन्यत्वात् ज्ञानम अनित्यम न भवति। ज्ञानस्य अनित्यत्वा अभ्युपगमे इन्द्रियैर्वा अन्तःकरणैर्वा ज्ञानम् उत्पद्यते इति वाच्यम्। नैयायिका रेफ्यूटेशन वी हैव सीन अर्लियर एज ज्ञान बीइंग अ रिजल्ट ऑफ संयोग विथ इंद्रिय मनस इत्यादि। नाउ सॉरी वी सॉ ज्ञान इज नित्य एंड इट इज आत्मस्वरूप। यू कैनॉट हैव टू नित्य। सो ज्ञान इज नॉट अ गुण। नाउ अंतकरणादि अजन्यत्वात् ज्ञानम अनित्यम न भवति। ज्ञान इज नॉट अ रिजल्ट ऑफ एनी संयोग। इट इज नॉट बॉर्न ड्यू टू इंद्रियस और अंतकरण। देयरफॉर इट इज नॉट अनित्य। एंड ज्ञानस्य अनित्यत्व अभ्युपगमे। इफ यू वेर टू कंसिडर ज्ञान एज अनित्य देन इंद्रिय और इंद्रियैर्वा अंतःकरणैर्वा ज्ञानम् उत्पद्यते इति वाच्यम्। देन दिस ज्ञान शुड बी अ रिजल्टेंट ऑफ समथिंग। व्हाट इज इट अ रिजल्टेंट ऑफ? चेतन। ज्ञान इन दिस केस पर्टिकुलरली चेतन। तन्न संगच्छते। इट कैनॉट बी बॉर्न आउट ऑफ इंद्रियास और आउट ऑफ अंतकरण। तथा ही सुषुप्तौ इंद्रियादीनि न सन्ति। इफ ज्ञान चेतन इज इंद्रिय जन्य देन इन सुषुप्ति इंद्रियास आर नॉट देयर। अंतकरण इज ऑल्सो रिजॉल्व्ड। सेम रिफ्यूटेशन विच वी हैव सीन अर्लियर व्हेन वी लुक्ड एट नैयायिका सिद्धांत नैयायिका दर्शन। सो सुषुप्तौ इंद्रियादीनि इंद्रियादीनि अंतकरण अपि न नास्ति। सो इंद्रियाणि न सन्ति अंतकरणोपि नास्ति। सुखज्ञानं तु उत्पद्यते बट सुखज्ञान इज देयर तन्न उत्पत्तुम अर्हति। दैट वुडंट हैव बीन देयर। सुषुप्तौ सुखस्य ज्ञान अनंगीकारे। इफ पीपल से दैट इन सुषुप्ति देयर इज नो ज्ञान सुखज्ञान इजंट देयर। देयर आर मेनी हु से दैट देन सुप्तोत्थितस्य अहम सुखम अस्वाप्सम इति सौषुप्त सुखस्य स्मरणम न स्यात्। देयर वोंट बी अ मेमोरी ऑफ सुख। देयर वोंट बी रिकलेक्शन। व्हाई? यद्वस्तु पूर्वम अनुभूतम तस्यैव स्मरणम भवे अननुभूतस्य स्मरणम न स्यात्। विदाउट अनुभव ऑफ सुख यू कैनॉट हैव स्मरण ऑफ सुख। स्मरण ऑफ सुख अनुभव इन सुषुप्ति शोज दैट देयर वॉज सुख अनुभव इन सुषुप्ति। सुप्तोत्थितस्य सौषुप्त सुख स्मरणस्य जायमानत्वात् सुषुप्तौ सुखस्य अनुभव अस्ति। तादृश ज्ञानोत्पादक इंद्रियादिकं सुषुप्तौ नास्ति। तस्मात् ज्ञानं नित्यम्। ज्ञान इज नित्य बिकॉज सुषुप्ति shows you without indriyas and without antakarana being manifest there is sukha anubhava which is recalled on waking up. Jnanam vinana kadapi atma bhavati. Atma which is nitya दैट इज नेवर विदाउट ज्ञान, इट इज ऑलवेज विद चेतना. तस्मा ज्ञानम आत्मन स्वरूपम यथा औष्ण्यम विना कदापि अग्नेर अभावाद औष्ण्यम अग्ने स्वरूपमेव. वी सॉ यस्टरडे अग्नि इज स्वरूप ऑफ उष्ण, औष्ण इज द स्वरूप ऑफ अग्नि बिकॉज देर इज नो अग्नि विदाउट औष्ण्य. तथा ज्ञानम अपि आत्मन स्वरूपमेव य आगमापायी स गुण औष्ण्यम ज्ञानम च आगमापाय रहिते. जस्ट लाइक द heat of fire is always seen whenever there is fire, similarly jnana is always there wherever atma is there. So atma is never bereft of jnana, and therefore jnana cannot be a guna. What is guna? That can come and go as there is sanyoga, but jnana is always there. Therefore, Atma is Jnana Swarupa. Jnana is not a guna of Atma. Tasmat te kramena agner atmanascha swarupa bhute. Yadvastu kadachit bhavati kadachit chan na bhavati tad agama paayi bhavati. So this is an elaboration of the point that we saw yesterday. So agama paayi bhavati guna ha agama paayi bhavati jnanam tu na agama paayi. अंतकरण वृत्ते हे उत्पत्ति विनाशो स्तः न ज्ञानस्य. नाउ दिस वृत्ति रूप ज्ञान इज आगमापायी. स्वरूप भूत चैतन्य रूप ज्ञान इज नॉट आगमापायी. उत्पत्ति विनाशावंतकरण वृत्ते हे भवतः. सो उत्पत्ति विनाशो अंतकरण वृत्ते हे भवतः. अंतकरण वृत्ति विच सीम्स टू बी चेतना, दैट काइंड ऑफ ज्ञान इज सब्जेक्ट टू उत्पत्ति एंड विनाश. बट दैट वृत्ति इज फिगरेटिवली कॉल्ड ज्ञान, रियली इट इज अ मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ चेतना इन द अंतकरण. सो ज्ञानस्य उत्पत्ति विनाशो न भवतः. सो दैट इज सेड हियर न ज्ञानस्य. आत्मस्वरूप भूतं ज्ञानं विशेष व्यवहार हेतुर न भवति किंतु ज्ञान सहिता वृत्तिर वृत्त्यारूढं वा ज्ञानं व्यवहार हेतुः. चेतना इज नॉट गुड फॉर व्यवहार, इट इज नॉट अपोज टू एनीथिंग ईदर. सो चैतन्य रूप ज्ञान और स्वरूप ज्ञान is never opposed to ajnana also. Otherwise, there cannot even be ajnana as an upadhi to atma. What is opposed to ajnana is vritti. So, vritti rupa jnana is opposed to ajnana. Just a moment, I think somebody... Sorry, there was a pop-up of somebody trying to get into the class. Okay, so antakarana vritti rupa jnana is opposed to ajnana, and without that vritti, there cannot be ajnana nasha. Whereas the swarupa jnana, which is always there, that is never opposed to ajnana. So bheda has to be done. As to jnana, which is agantuka, is vritti rupa jnana, which is actually vijnana as per the kshanika vijnana vadis. That is why they think that consciousness itself, chaitanya, atma itself is agantuka, is kshanika. This is a misunderstanding. And this is a similar mistake that a nayayika or someone else who says that chetana comes and goes, that person would be making. So, किंतु ज्ञान सहिता वृत्ति, ज्ञान सहिता वृत्ति ही वृत्यारूढ़ वा ज्ञानम व्यवहार हेतु. सो ज्ञान सहित चेतन सहित चेतन आत्मा दैट चैतन्य सहिता वृत्ति ही और वृत्यारूढ़ वृत्यारूढ़ ज्ञानम इज व्यवहार हेतु. इधर यू से वृत्ति इज अलॉन्ग विद चैतन्य और यू से वृत्ति इज वृत्या आरूढ़ ज्ञानम. ज्ञानम इज राइडिंग द वृत्ति. दीज आर ऑल फिगरेटिव फ्रेजेस. इट इज नॉट लिटरल. The Upadhi is also not literal really. You cannot limit the Chaitanya, but these are all ways to describe something which cannot be described. So there will be limitations in the language, whichever phrase you use. Vritya, how can there be Chaitanya? So there people take literally and then ask, how can Vritti have Chaitanya Arudha on it? So this is all literal interpretation of Arudhattam. Or ज्ञान सहिता वृत्ति ही आर देर टू थिंग्स. इफ द तात्पर्य इज क्लियर वी शुड नॉट फोकस ऑन व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज द लैंग्वेज. लैंग्वेज फोकस इज ऑफ अ नैयायिका. एज लॉन्ग एज वी गेट व्हाट इज बीइंग सेड इन द मिथ्या प्रपंच देर इज नो क्लियर डिस्क्रिप्शन पॉसिबल. वी से माया सर्वस्य संभवत. व्हाई इट इज सो दैट इज हाउ इट इज. फॉर एवरी व्हाई the person who is looking for an answer, he has missed that why not is right there. Why not? Person says, why should it be described in this manner? Do you have a better way? Please give that. There is no better way. Whoever thinks that I have a better way to express something has not studied enough, because everything that has been expressed by a later, so to say, philosopher has been expressed by everyone earlier, by someone or the other earlier. We just don't have access to it. We have not studied it. All these questions that are there, they have all been answered. That is why there are many prakriyas to answer the questions, whichever fits a particular sadhaka, whichever clarifies the doubts of particular sadhaka, that prakriya is good for that person. Similarly, the phrase also, no, I don't think that vritti can be, jnana can be arudha on vritti. Okay, jnana sahita vritti, if that works, you take that. So, kintu jnana sahita vritti hi vrityarudam va jnanam vyavahara hetu. Do you understand that jnana, chetana cannot act by itself? Do you understand that antakkarana jada cannot act by itself? Indriyas cannot act by themselves? Antakkarana vritti itself cannot take place without chaitanya backing? That is all the tatparya is. There is a mix-up. There are, so to say, two entities. The two entities are not equally real. Chaitanya is real, the other is Mithya. If you understand that, the teaching is over there. Whichever phrase fits, you use that. Iyam eva. So, iyam avachhedavadasya rithihi. So, avachhedavada explains in this manner. Abhasavadetu abhasa sahitaya vrittya vyavaharam bhavati. Then another vada describes in a different manner. There are technical differences which you have seen multiple times earlier. So, abhasa vadetu, abhasa sahitaya vrittya vyavaharo bhavati. There is no limitation due to an upadhi here. There is a reflection in the upadhi. There is an abhasa of the upadhi which is acting into the atma. Atma seems to act out. Lelayati iva. ध्यायति इव लीलायति इव इव इवकारा इज देयर. आभास द्वारा वा साक्षात् वृत्ति द्वारा वा आत्मस्वरूप ज्ञानेन एव सर्वव्यवहार सिद्ध्यति. वेदर यू टेक आभासवाद और यू टेक अवच्छेदवाद भामतिकारास इधर वे व्यवहार इज पॉसिबल ओनली विथ वृत्ति और विथ आभास. ज्ञानम विना तु न कोऽपि व्यवहार सिद्ध्यति. इत्थं सर्व प्रकाशक ज्ञान स्वरूप आत्मा एव तस्मात् आत्मा चिद्रूपः. विदाउट दिस चैतन्य आत्मा नो व्यवहार इज पॉसिबल एंड बाय इटसेल्फ इट कैनॉट एक्ट. देयरफॉर देयर हैज टू बी अ मिक्सअप. आत्मा आनंद स्वरूपः. सो वी सीन सद्रूप एंड चिद्रूप. नाउ आत्मा इज आनंद स्वरूपः. हाउ सो? आत्मा एव आनंद स्वरूप विषय आनंदो नास्ति. इन विषय देयर इज नो आनंद. वी हैव सीन राइट फ्रॉम तत्वबोध और बेसिक एनी बेसिक टेक्स्ट वी हैव सीन विषय आनंद इज इन देयर. That is why Viveka, and then next step is Vairagya. If you have Viveka that Ananda is not in Vishayas, then Vairagya is a natural resultant. Then Samadhi Shatka Sampatti Mumukshutvam. Now this Ananda in Vishaya which you see, what is it due to? That is due to your own Swarupa, where you rest back when there is no desire clouding the Antakkarana. Antakkarana is not drawn outside by Indriyas, which are drawn outside towards Vishayas due to the Raga towards the Vishaya. Then Dvesha has the flip side. So the Antakkarana not being clouded by Raga Dvesha, when the Vishaya Raga is met or Vishaya Dvesha is successfully concluded, that time there is no clouding in the Antakkarana. That kind of a Shuddha Antakkarana, like a clear mirror, reflects the Bimba brightly. So the Ananda Swarupa of the Atma is reflected there. There is an Ananda Vritti which is wrongly attributed to the Vishaya. So this is the setup in which everyone is confused as to attributing the Atma Ananda to the Vishayas. Vishaya Ananda Nasti, Atma Ananda Swarupa Asti, Atma Yadi Ananda Rupa Nasya Tada Vishaya Sambandat Swarupa Anandasya Bhanam Na Sambhavet. Due to Vishaya Sanyoga, there wouldn't have been Ananda had Atma not been Ananda Swarupa. Why? Because Vishaya does not have Ananda. Had Vishaya had Ananda. If Vishaya were to have had Ananda, then Atma Sanyoga bringing Sukha in the Atma, as someone would erroneously conclude, everyone should have the same Ananda due to the Sanyoga with the same Vishaya, which is not true at all. Pooja Swamiji would give a modern example to the modern audience as a joke, saying that look at a person who is divorcing his spouse, his or her spouse. Generally, the perspective is explained from the man's perspective there. So one man is divorcing his wife, whereas the other is going to marry her. So where is the sukha in the spouse there? Otherwise, the first one wouldn't be trying to get rid of her. So he used to, yeah, it's a joke, but then this is what our interaction with Vishayas is. The person who is selling you some goods at the store, he values money more than the object you are trying to buy. You value it more, therefore the Shobana Adhyasa. The Sukha in that Vishaya that you are trying to acquire wouldn't be available at all if there were to be real Sukha in the Vishaya. Why would anyone give it to you? Be it for money. So money brings that person more sukha than that vishaya which he is giving you. And this is true in each and every transaction. Somebody values something more than you. You value something else more than that person. Therefore, transactions are possible. This vyavahara is due to adhyasa, shobana adhyasa, subjectivity. So Atma has to be Ananda Swarupa because there is Ananda Anubhava in the Antakkarana. There is an Ananda Vritti when there is Atma and Vishaya Sanyoga. And we have established that Ananda is not in Vishaya, but there is Ananda Anubhava on Vishaya Sanyoga. That is due to Vishaya helping you manifest your own Ananda. Therefore, Ananda is your Swarupa. An interesting way it is expressed. Vishaya tu ananda nasti iti chaturtha tarange eva pratipaditam. It has been explained in the fourth taranga itself. We are in the sixth taranga. Vishaya yadi ananda bhavet tada yasmin vishaya kasyachit sukham bhavati tasmin eva vishaya anyasya dukham utpadyamanam na ghatet. What we just saw. Tatahi agne sparshe na agni kitasya sarpa darshane na sarpinyaha simha darshane na simhyaha anando bhavati अन्येषां पुरुषाणां तु दुःखमेव भवति। सो दि अग्निस्पर्श ब्रिंग्स दुख टू दि ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, सर्प दर्शन ऑल्सो ब्रिंग्स फियर देयरफॉर दुख, सिंह दर्शन डेफिनेटली दुख, बट देयर ओन स्पीशीज दे हैव सुख, द ऑपोजिट जेंडर। सो हियर अग्नि अग्नेः स्पर्श अग्निस्पर्श देयर इज एन अग्नि कीट विच फाइंड्स Agni very attractive. It is attracted towards the fire, but not for human beings. So human beings want to keep away from fire unless you know it is cold. So you keep yourself warm, but you don't touch the fire. Similarly, sarpa darshana, sarpa is scary for everyone, but not to a sarpini. Simha for the lioness. The lion is not scary. They are attracted towards each other. Anyesham purushanam tu dukkham eva bhavati tanna upapadyet yadi vishaya anandam bhavet. So the sadhu uses an example which is not debatable at all. Because if you say no, you know, there are many people who like sweets. You can't give a sweet example there. Here, you know, sarpa, most of people will be afraid of sarpa, lion, etc. So therefore that example is easily explainable. There no explanation needed there. So tanna upapadyeta yadi vishaya anandam bhavet, if the vishaya, lion, agni, sarpa ityadi, they themselves had ananda, then human beings would also be drawn towards them. It is not true. Siddhante tu agni kitasya agni sparshechha bhavati तदा तस्य चंचलाय बुद्धौ, सॉरी दिस इज देयर इज अ टाइपो हियर, सम लेटर्स आर मिसिंग ऑन द एंड। सो तस्य शुड दिस बी चंचलाय बुद्धौ स्वरूपानंद भारम न भवति, नॉट श्योर विच लेटर इज मिसिंग हियर। डज एनीवन हैव व्हाट वर्ड इज दिस? चंचलायाम, चंचलायाम बुद्धौ, राइट? या चंचलायाम बुद्धौ, दैट्स राइट। या थैंक्स। समहाउ यू नो इफ यू रीड इट टुगेदर इट विल बी इजी। सो तदा तस्य चंचलायाम बुद्धौ स्वरूपानंदम स्वरूपानंदम भारम न भवति। सो सप्तमी बुद्धौ चंचला इज क्वालिफाइंग दैट। सो चंचला या बुद्धि तस्यां बुद्धौ चंचलायाम बुद्धौ स्वरूपानंद भानम न भवति। कदा? यदा अग्निकीटस्य अग्निस्पर्शेच्छा भवति, देयर इज एन इच्छा विच क्लाउड्स द माइंड ऑफ द अग्निकीट, दैट इच्छा इज ऑफ अग्निस्पर्श। सो दैट इज सिद्धांत। एनी इच्छा क्लाउड्स द अंतकरण द बुद्धि एंड देन चंचलायां बुद्धौ इन दैट बुद्धि विच इज नाउ not sthira swarupananda bhanam na bhavati, it takes one away from one's own swarupananda. Siddhe tu agni sambandhe kshana matram ichha duri bhavati, then what happens? Siddhe tu agni sambandhe, once agni sambandha takes place, ichha is met, this was the agni kita, then what happens? The ichha, so vishaya sambandhe, vishaya sambandhe sati विषय इच्छा न भवति। व्हाई? बिकॉज़ इट इज मेट, द विषय इच्छा इज फुलफिल्ड एंड ऑन फुलफिलमेंट द क्लाउडिंग ऑफ द अंतकरण गोज अवे बिकॉज़ द विषय इच्छा हैज बीन फुलफिल्ड। देयरफॉर सिद्धेतु विषय संबंधे वी कैन टेक अ सिद्धेतु विषय संबंधे क्षणमात्रम इच्छा दूरी भवति, क्षणमात्रम फॉर दैट मोमेंट बिफोर द अदर डिजायर क्रॉप्स अप, दैट डिजायर इज मेट, देयरफॉर देयर इज नो desire clouding the mind. Tada nichchalayam tasyam buddho swarupanando bhati anyesham purushanam tu agni sambandhe ichha na bhavati kintu padarthantara sambandhe ichha asti. So it is all subjective, that is what I said. So we know this So anyway, just for completion, I'll just go through this. Agni Keta, we know Agni, Upajeevi, Keta Vishesha. Some Keta Vishesha, some specific Keta who is drawn towards the Agni. Survives on that Agni, so to say. Yasmad ekasminya vishaye keshanchit sukham itaresham dukkham cha bhavati tasmad vishayah niyamena svavishayaka ichha rahitanam svavishayaka ichha sahitanam api purushanam sukahetur bhavati. So same vishaya being the source of sukha for some and source of dukkha for the others, therefore niyamena svavishaye svavishayaka ichha rahitanam the same object is the source of sukha and dukkha also, and for the same person who has sukha ichha, so the vishaya ichha, then vishaya ichha sahita, one who has the one who likes a vishaya, particular vishaya, then svavishayaka ichha sahitana, there he'll have dukkha, but once that goes away, that vishaya is met, vishaya desire is met, then what happens is that person gets sukha. For the other, when that vishaya goes away, because he does not have raga, he has dvesha towards the same vishaya, when it goes away, there is sukha. So niyamena svavishayaka ichha rahitanam svavishayaka ichha sahitanam api purushanam sukahetur bhavati, same vishaya. Kintu svavishayaka ichha sahitanam purushanam svavishayaha svapraptya ichha tiraskara dvara antarmukhaya murtu priyamoda pramoda paryaya rupa atma swarupananda pratibimbasya nimittam bhavati. Tasmad vishaya ananda karanata vivicharati kincha vishaya praptyaya वा एकांत देश देश सेवनेन वा जायमानो या इच्छायाः भावः स प्रतिबिंब सुखस्य नियमेन कारणं भवति. सो ऑल द ग्रेडेशंस ऑफ प्रिय मोद एंड प्रमोद आर ड्यू टू दिस इच्छा बीइंग इंटेंस एंड ग्रेजुअली डिक्रीजिंग. द क्लाउडिंग ऑफ द अंतःकरण रिड्यूसेस ग्रेजुअली व्हेन द विषय is proximal to anubhava, once anubhava, and then finally resolves, and thereby there is gradation of atma sukha anubhava. Atma yadi ananda rupa nasyat tada antarmukhayam vrittau yaha ananda bhavati sa na bhavitum arhati tasmad atma ananda rupaha ayam sarva prakarana nishkarsha. So sarva prakarana nishkarsha kaha, this is how the siddhanta explains that ananda vritti takes place when there is antarmukhatvam. Antarmukhatvam is possible when bahirmukha person becomes antarmukha. And why does he become antarmukha? Is because the desire is met or it isn't there. Either it is met or it is initially itself not there. That's why the ananda mimamsa in Taittiriya Upanishad, it explains that. Shrotriyasya चाकामहतस्य श्रोत्रियस्य च अकामहतस्य यः कामेन न हतः यः विरागी तस्यापि सुखं भवति. हौ इट इज हंड्रेड फोल्ड मोर देन दी उपाधि दैट अदरवाइज प्रोवाइड्स फॉर दी हाईएस्ट सुख अनुभव. देर इज हंड्रेड फोल्ड सुख इफ देर इज वैराग्य टुवर्ड्स दी ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ that upadhi. Shrotriyasya cha akamahatasya means kamena na hatasya, one who is not under the pressure of influence of kama, for that person there is more sukha, 100 times more. 100 is just a number, many times more than the upadhi provides. And then in the same upadhi one can have up to hiranyagarbha kind of sukha by vairagya. That is what is explained in the Ananda Mimamsa, and that is what is sarva prakarana nishkarshaha. It is the conclusion of all prakaranas. Sacha padartha antare ichha agni sambandha na duri bhavati. तस्मा चंचले अंतकरणे अग्नि संबंधाद आनंदो न भवति। सो एनीवे वी हैव सीन दैट देयर इज चंचला अंतकरण डज नॉट लेट द आत्मस्वरूप मैनिफेस्ट विच इज आनंद। आनंद डज नॉट मैनिफेस्ट इन अ चंचल बुद्धि, चंचल अंतकरण। इच्छा निवृत्तौ स्वरूपानंद भान प्रकार निरूपणम् अत्र इयं शंका स्यात्। सो there is a doubt regarding this swarupa ananda being manifest once there is ichha nivritti antakaranasya ichha roopa vritti vishe praptya vinashta nimitta bhavat na anya vritti utpadyate vrittim vina swarupa anandasya bhanam nasya tasmad vishe eva anando asti iti। So vishaya has ananda, why? This is an aropa, there is a shanka। The doubt is that antakkaranasi ichha roopa vrittihi vishaya praptya vinashta। Now once this ichha is met, the vishaya ichha is fulfilled, then the vritti, that vishaya ichha vritti has gone। So nimitta bhavat na anya vrittir utpadyate, now there is no other vritti। The vritti for the ichha vritti was the vishaya ichha। Vishaya being in one santakarana caused that vishaya ichha vritti। Now that vishaya ichha being fulfilled, there is no vritti at all because there is no other nimitta for another vritti to come up। In that case, how is it that vrittim vina swarupananda bhana is taking place? So vrittim vina swarupanandasya bhanam na syat, you have to have vritti for ananda anubhava also, and there is no nimitta for that। So this is the shanka, tasmad vishaya eva ananda asti iti। So ananda is in vishaya because there is no vritti at all once the vishaya ichha vritti goes away। Naisha shanka yujyate, this is not a tenable doubt। Why? Ichha roopa antakkarana vrittihi nasti iti satyam। It is true that so much is true, in the doubt what is valid, conclusion is wrong। Vishaya ananda, vishaya has ananda, that conclusion is wrong। But this much is correct that ichha roopa antakkarana vrittihi nasti, that has ichha has gone away, that is true, therefore ichha roopa vritti isn't there। Satyamapi ichha roopa vrittau tatra anando na prakashet, when that kind of vritti was there, that time there was no sukha anubhava। Ichha roopa vrittihi rajasi, the rajasi vritti cannot give you ananda, ananda can only be in the sattvika vritti। Ananda prakasha sattvika vrittau eva syat tathapi vanchita padartha labhe sati tadrusha vishaya swarupam vishayikartum jnana roopa antakaranasya ya vrittihi udeti sa sattviki। There is a vritti which takes place whatever be your desire towards, the vishaya is tamasika or rajasika, the vritti is in keeping with the vishaya, and so much is the hurt or sorrow also, dukkha, once the vishaya prapti takes place, then that vritti, rajasi tamasi vritti goes away, it can be sattviki also goes away because it is all vishaya vritti। On vishaya prapti tattat vishaya vritti goes away, what vritti comes up is this sattvika vritti after that because it is in keeping with atmana, because there is an antarmukhatvam। So tatapi vanchita padartha labhe sati tadrusha vishaya swarupam vishayikartum jnana roopa antakaranasya vrittihi udeti sa sattviki। So in keeping with the vishaya, the jnana vritti which is there, not the ichha vritti, the jnana vritti which is there, that jnana is always sattvika, that vritti jnana vritti roopa। So jnana roopa antakaranasya vritti rudeti sa vrittihi sattviki bhavati। Sattva sanjayate jnanam iti sattva guna jnanam utpadyate iti niyamaha। Jnana itself won't be possible if there is no sattva there, so sattva being there, there is sattvika vritti, that sattvika vritti is ananda roopa। तस्याम सात्विक वृत्तौ आनंदो भाति परंतु सा ज्ञान रूपा वृत्तिर बहिर्मुखा। दैट घटाकार पटाकार वृत्ति विच इज टेकिंग प्लेस दैट वृत्ति इज वॉट इट इज बहिर्मुख तस्याः पृष्ठभाग स्थित अंतकरणोपेत चैतन्य स्वरूपानंद यः तस्य ग्रहणं तया वृत्त्या न स्यात् द वृत्ति विच इज टेकिंग प्लेस आउटसाइड बहिर्मुखा वृत्ति घटपटादि वृत्ति पृष्ठभाग स्थित अंतकरण उपहित चैतन्य स्वरूपानंद यः दैट स्वरूपानंद विच इज हिडन बिहाइंड दैट वृत्ति तस्य ग्रहणं तया वृत्त्या न स्यात् दैट इज नॉट टेकिंग प्लेस हियर व्हेन घटाकार वृत्ति पटाकार वृत्ति टेक्स प्लेस दैट टाइम द स्वरूप वृत्ति इज नॉट टेकिंग प्लेस इट इज हिडन बिहाइंड इट इज देयर बट इट इज हिडन बिहाइंड अंडरलाइन देयर तस्मात् तस्या वृत्तौ विषयोपहित चैतन्य स्वरूपानंदो न भाति इट शुड बी हियर तस्य ग्रहणं तया वृत्त्या न स्यात् तच्च विषयोपहित चैतन्यम् आत्मनः न भिन्नम् तस्माद् आत्मानन्दय विषये भाति इति कथ्यते तस्या ज्ञानरूपवृत्तेरुत्पत्तो विषयेण सह नेत्रे नेत्रादीनां सम्बन्धः हेतुः सो तस्यां सात्विकवृत्तौ आनन्दः भाति देयर इज एन आनंद भारा इन दि विषय व्हेन विषयवृत्ति इज टेकिंग प्लेस व्हाट इज हैपनिंग देयर आनंद इज फ्रॉम दि अंतकरण इट्स फ्रॉम दि आत्म स्वरूपानंद इट्सेल्फ इज मैनिफेस्टिंग देयर बट इट इज नॉट नोन व्हाय बिकॉज इट इज हिडन सो देयर इज अ ज्ञान वृत्ति घट ज्ञान वृत्ति सो घटाकार वृत्ति इज घट ज्ञान व्हेन दैट टेक्स प्लेस एंड वन हैज इच्छा फॉर दैट घटा देन दिस घटा ब्रिंग्स इन आनंद वन एट्रीब्यूट्स द आनंद देयर बिकॉज आनंद इज डेफिनेटली मैनिफेस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ सत्व However, that ananda is not seen to be from the atma because it is hidden. Tasmat, so tasya prushtabhaga sthita antakrana upahita chaitanya, which is already there in that vritti. Swarupanandaha, that swarupananda is hidden. Therefore, tasya grahanam taya vrittya nasyat. Tasmat tasya vritto vishe upahita chaitanya swarupanando bhati. So, sir, not na here, this is vishe upahita. सो विषय उपहित चैतन्य स्वरूपानंदो भाति तस्या वृत्तौ इन दैट वृत्ति दि भान इज ऑफ दि आनंद विच इज विषय उपहित चैतन्य चैतन्य आनंद इज नॉट मैनिफेस्ट कंप्लीट बट इट इज लिमिटेड बाय द विषय तच्च विषय उपहित चैतन्यम आत्मनः न भिन्नम बट इट इज द सेम हिडन आनंद विच इज नॉट रिवील्ड देन देयरफॉर It is wrongly construed as being due to the Vishaya. Tasmat Atmanandayo Vishaya Bhati Iti Kathyate. So people who think that there is Ananda in the Vishaya, they have missed the Swarupananda and therefore it is the same Swarupananda which is manifest there. Tasya Jnana Rupa Vrittehe Utpatto Vishena Sa Netradinam Sambandha Hetuhu. So Vishaya Sukha has Hetu of the Netra इत्यादि संबंध एंड दिस इज व्हाट द नैयायिक और द अदर्स हैव आल्सो मिसअंडरस्टूड दैट दैट इज द रीजन फॉर विषय सुख दैट इज द रीजन फॉर सुख एंड देयरफॉर दैट इज द रीजन फॉर द चैतन्य आल्सो अर्लियर बट इट इज रॉन्ग देयर इज अनदर वे टू लुक एट इट व्हिच विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट अथवा सुखम नित्यम सुख प्रकाशम व्यापक नाम रूपे अधिष्ठान बुद्धि बुद्धिर्दृक्यत्व निर्वापारम सर्व वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्यक परम तदेव अन्नमत्व निधि में निश्चिता मति ही तत्सत्